carbon Miata, diamond stitched or quilted leather interior mats. Are they worth it? Should you get them? Let's check them out.
I have the trunk lid liner, and I also have the trunk liner itself that goes inside the trunk. And since the exhaust noises do kind of come in through the trunk and then into the cabin, it does actually help reduce some of that noise, and it can make the interior just that little bit more comfortable. In addition, I think they look pretty neat. I mean, it does give the car a little bit more of a luxurious feel, especially with the trunk lid here. Without this thing here in place, when you open it, it's just a big sheet of metal with a bunch of holes in it. Having this mat here does make it look just a little bit tidier. This is an imitation leather. It feels like it's decent quality and it's gonna last almost forever. It's probably gonna outlast the car itself. What about the interior? Well, my car is right-hand drive because I'm here in Japan. As you can see, the right-hand drive version doesn't fit all that great. There's kind of a limit to how far this mat can go up in the front of the footwell. And because it's hitting that, it's bending. And that bend over there is kind of pushing that pressure all the way back, and it's causing these little kinks along here. You can see that I've cut out that part over there, the front of the footwell, so that it doesn't hit all this stuff up here. I could have done a better job of cutting it closer to that line, but I'm not too worried about that because you can't really see it unless you get your head down really low. On this side, I've tucked it underneath the center console. And on the left side, what I had to do to get rid of the kinks is tuck the mat underneath this door sill. And I did that all the way up here. I had to cut out a small little section here where it gets closer to this panel because it's really tricky tucking it under there. So I cut out a small little section and then tucked it all in. You can see the door sill kind of floating up just a little bit, and oh well, that's just kind of like a little compromise you'll have to live with. And I also add that the ones that I got are the ones that have these removable mats. You just got to turn these two tabs and you can just pull it right out. Over on the driver's side, this is actually what I'm most concerned about because this is where I spend the most of my time. The first thing is this little part here that's supposed to bend over and cover up the footrest didn't really line up very well, so I ended up cutting it out. I've just kind of done a little cutout over here so I can bolt down the footrest properly. On this side, it's kind of lining up nicely with the right side of the car, so I'm not gonna tuck this in. But what I did end up doing is, just to kind of help with that kink, I tucked in all of this side here. Now the other problem that I had, and this was actually a big issue, is the lip of the mat where it used to be was just at the right point where if I was to put the accelerator pedal right to the floor and lift my foot off it, the pedal would get caught under the mat, just a tiny bit. What I ended up doing is just cut a little notch over here. So now the accelerator pedal is definitely not gonna get caught on that. Plenty of clearance all around it. One complaint that I have, and this might just be due to my height and the size of my feet. When I've got the clutch pedal all the way down, and as I'm lifting my foot up, sometimes my heel gets caught right here. Now I have learned to kind of adjust how I position my feet, and I've kind of made a habit of that, so it doesn't really happen anymore. But I wish I didn't have to do that. I wish that, you know, I could really just get in here and not have to worry about that at all. So what I might end up doing is just removing this mat here altogether, especially for track days. Now the last thing to talk about is the roof liner. Mine is a power retractable hardtop, so there is the roof liner that they have available that's in the same diamond stitch pattern. They're only going to be held on with adhesive Velcro strips, and there's Velcro strips that are attached to the headliners themselves, and they're supposed to just kind of press on. The problem that I had is when I left the car parked out in the sun, which anyone's gonna do with a daily driver, the heat would soften the adhesive and the roof liner would come dropping down. Now it's never actually dropped down on me while driving, but imagine if that did happen and you're, you know, driving on the highway at high speeds, that could be a real safety hazard. So do not get the hardtop and do not rely on the adhesive backing that they have. I even had to try using super strong Gorilla double-sided tape to hold it up. That did a much better job than the original Velcro adhesive stuff that came with it. Eventually, once the weather started to get warm, one of the sides just came dropping down. So do not buy the carbon Miata roof liners.
So after all said and done, knowing what I know now about how much trouble it is to get these to fit right, would I buy them? Probably not. They're pretty expensive mats for what they are. And sure, they look nice and they do kind of reduce the road noise and things, but for the amount you're paying, I would expect them to fit a whole lot better, and I'd expect them to not require any cutting. So I do not at all recommend anyone goes out and spends their money on any of Carbon Miata's interior mats. I mean, the trunk liner, that's all right, but for anything that goes in here in the cabin, get someone else.